All right, in this video, we're going to be graphing the solution set to linear inequalities. So here's an example of a linear inequality. It's just like a linear equation, except instead of a y equals, it has a y and then a inequality symbol. Greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. Now, solutions to linear inequalities are any ordered pair that makes the inequality true. So again, we're looking for true statements. So in this example, we're just checking to see if negative 2, 4 is a solution to this inequality here. Y is less than 2x plus 1. So in order to do that, one way is to just put negative 2 in for x and 4 in for y. We're going to substitute or replace those values there and see if it makes a true statement. So here we go. So we put 4 in for y and negative 2 in for x. Now over here, we're going to do order of operations and simplify here. So 2 times negative 2, that's going to be a negative 4. And then negative 4 plus 1 makes negative 3. And in this case here, 4 is not less than negative 3. So this, when substituted in for our inequality here, does not make a true statement, makes a false statement. So negative 2, 4 is not a solution. Now for this example here, we're checking to see if 3, 1 is a solution to y is greater than x minus 4. So we're going to take our original inequality, substitute 3 in for x and 1 in for y. So let's replace those numbers and we're checking to see if this makes a true statement. We're going to do order of operations or simplify here. 3 minus 4 is negative 1. And in this case here, 1 is indeed greater than negative 1. That's a true statement. So 3, 1 is a solution to this inequality here. Now, when we're going to graph the entire solution set, if we have strictly less than or greater than, we're going to use a dashed line because those points on that boundary line are not going to be solution. If it's or equal to, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, we'll use a solid line because those points on the line are going to be solutions to our inequality. And then for greater thans, we're going to shade above our boundary line. For less than or less than or equal to, we're going to shade below the boundary line. We'll do some examples so you can see how this works. Here we go. So we're going to graph y is greater than 2x plus 3. So we're going to start out by graphing the boundary line. And in this case here, the boundary line is going to be y equals 2x plus 3. And since it's strictly greater than, we're going to use a dashed line. So here we go. So this is in slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b. There's our y-intercept at 3. So we put a dot there. And then our slope is going to be 2. So we're going to go up 1, 2 over 1 for the slope. And there's another point there. And then we can draw our boundary line through there. Again, this is going to be a dashed boundary line because it's strictly greater than. So now that we have our boundary line, now we're going to get ready to start shading. So in this case here, it's y is greater than. So we just take any point along this line here and we go above the line and that's where we're going to shade. So this area in here, this is all of our solution coordinates points on the line are not solutions because it's dashed and anything over here is not a solution. So quick question, is negative 2, 3 a solution? Well, let's look. Negative 2, 3 is right here. It's part of the shaded area. So yes, it is a solution. What about 3, 1? Let's look. 3, 1 is right here. It is not part of the shaded. So no, not a solution. What about 4, 0? Let's look here. 4, 0, right there, not a solution. 0, 4. Well, 0, 4 is right here on the y-axis, and it is shaded. And let's look at one more point, negative 2, negative 1. Negative 2, negative 1 is right there. It is on the line. Since this is greater than, and the line is dashed, which means the line is dashed, it is not going to be a solution. So no for this one here. Another example, here we're going to graph y is less than or equal to 2x minus 3. So again, we're going to start by graphing our boundary line. Since it's or equal to, we're going to use a solid line. So this is in slope-intercept form, mx plus b. So negative 3 is the y-intercept, and then the slope is 2. So we're going to go up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1. And then our boundary line, again, is going to be solid. This is going to be less than or equal to, so we're going to shade below the line. So we look at any point along this line, and we're going to shade down from there. So there's all the solutions there. Any of these coordinates are going to be solutions to y is less than or equal to 2x minus 3. Another example here, we're going to graph the solutions to y is less than negative 4/3 x plus 2. So we start with a y-intercept. That's going to be at 2 because this is slope-intercept form for our boundary line. And now we're going to go, the slope is going to be down 4 over 3. So down 1, 2, 3, 4 over 1, 2, 3. And there's another point there. It's not or equal to, it's strictly less than. So that's going to be a dashed line for our boundary line. And then it is less than, so we're going to shade below the line. So any look at your line anywhere there, and we're going to shade straight down. So there's the solution set to y is less than negative 4/3 x plus 2. Last example here, we're going to graph the solutions to y is greater than or equal to negative 5/2 x minus 4. So here we go. We're going to start by graphing the boundary line. It's going to be solid because it's or equal to there. So we'll start on the y-intercept, negative 4. There we go. Now we're going to do our slope. It's going to be down 5 and over 2. Down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oops, we ran out of room. So instead of going down 5, right 2, we'll go the opposite direction. We'll go up 5 and left 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, and we can put a dot there. Again, this is going to be a solid line because it's or equal to. And it's greater than, so that means we're going to shade above the line, above the line. There we go. So any of these points here are going to be solutions on the line, more solutions over here, not a solution. So remember, when we're graphing these linear inequalities, the solution sets to them, if it's we start with the boundary line, and then if it's strictly less than or greater than, it's going to be a dashed line, like here. If it's or equal to, it'll be a solid line. And then we shade the solution area. Greater than, we shade above the line. If it's going to be less than, then we shade below the line.